Hi and welcome. This is Johannes. I'm a field application engineer at Vector Stuttgart. Today I want to talk about the lock and commit concept in PREEvision. PREEvision is designed for carrying out complex EE projects in really large organizations. So we have usually EE development team which are using a PREEvision for their centralized backbone. And you see here on the right picture that the lock and commit conflict-free work topic is just one of many multi-user operations which this central database is responsible or can carry out. With the lock and commit concept, we want to enable and ensure that multiple team members can work without any data collision and ensure conflict-free working and an efficient cooperation within the team. And the good thing here is that all operations can be executed directly on the technical artifacts, and whatever it might be, a requirement, maybe an ECU or maybe also an application software component. If we take a look onto the mechanism itself that is implemented, so we see here user one has currently the logs reserved on the database for the ECU here. And he can work there until he will do a commit, which will transfer the information from the local client towards the database. And just until then, user 2 and user 3 would be able to modify and reserve another log for that particular ECU. Those icons and many more will help to identify what is currently going on from the database perspective on your local client. So let's have a look into a model which is connected to a database. Here we have a product line which serves as an example. And here you already can see those logs which I have pointed out to on the slide before. And when you hover with the mouse onto the icon, you see the type of log and the user and when this artifact is logged. That gives you a good feedback. And right now, I really don't care about how this mechanism works, communicating from my local client to the database. I just continue with my daily work, assuming I need to create another requirement, for instance. And what is going to happen is that here we have a shared log reserved onto the database for this particular artifact, and also here this new artifact will or was created just locally, and that's the reason why we have here this blue pencil. And then I'm going to apply a change to the naming and also continue my work here, and I can now create here another requirement. Advantages of this conflict-free working environment is that I'm not able to modify or even move and change this particular artifact, nor this one. So I'm not able to change the name or even delete it. You see also this is grayed out. We have now several options on how to continue my workflow. So either I could now commit my changes to the database by doing a commit. So doing a commit either is possible via this tool button here, or I can go to the context menu and trigger the commit here. And both options will hand over this, what I have changed locally, to the database. By doing so, I will commit all of my changes towards the database, and here I can add a comment. And then my changes will be handed over to the database, and by doing so, I'm releasing the logs, and those things will be now accessible through other colleagues if they will do an update from the server. The alternative to commit is the undo all own logs option in the context menu, which reverts all the changes to the last commit count. So first of all, the commit count is displayed here where we see our online status, the commit count. So we have now 8 commits on that database. And here we have the timestamp when the last commit has happened. Additionally, now let's assume we are not satisfied with the changes that have been applied since the last commit count and I want to undo it. Now I can go back or I can access the context menu, and here I find the undo all own logs. This revert all the options that I'd done, and now we're back to the starting point of the commit count 8. Another option which I would highlight is the commit and relog option in the context menu. For instance, again, a requirement, and let's assume we have finalized it and we want to hand over this information to our colleagues, but in the same time log it again for further development. And that's where we need the commit and relog option in the context menu. Commit and relog, and this will commit the changes to the database and at the same time lock it again. So now the blue pencil becomes a green pencil. And then our colleagues could make an update, and then they would see the locked requirement A in the database. I already pointed out the way of working with the automatic locking. So you start working and PREEvision locks all of the required artifacts automatically, and the user doesn't have to take care and doesn't have to worry about this kind of like mechanism. But what if you would like to in advance lock all of the required artifacts that you would like to modify? Therefore, we offer the option which is called lock. This is accessible via the context menu, and here we have two different options. One will be just for the selected artifact, which is the first one, and this locks also all the entire children. So now I can apply changes and there would be no further lock request. What happens if I will do this where here artifacts are locked? I will do this just to show it to you, and then we get a message telling us, okay, not all of the artifacts could be locked. I'm going to the information view, and then I see here, okay, we have this particular package, which is locked by another user. If you want to get some more knowledge into the lock and commit concept in PREEvision, kindly have a look into the menu, which is there wherever you have PREEvision installed. And thanks for watching and see you soon. Bye.